Shark versus Dyson. Let's go head to head. You've seen the adverts, but that's too soft. We are gonna put them truly to the test with some tough challenges. Flour, pasta, cornflakes, Lego, and even some glass. So we're testing out the Dyson V11 with hair detangling technology. Advertised with a 60-minute run time, 4.5 hours charge time, 3 kilos in weight, whole machine filtration with a 4.7 liter bin capacity. The price, £430. Unless you buy it on a Black Friday deal like we did, and you get the money off. And on the other side, we have the Shark cordless stick vacuum with a 0.7 liter bin, a 40 minute run time. They don't tell us the charge time, and it is a little bit heavier, coming in at 4.7 kilos. But it does have a bend if you need it. The price, just a snip at £190. Oops, I dropped my flour. Let's give it a go. Not bad at all. Out of 10, gotta be a 9. No boost needed. All on medium mode, it's all gone. It's 10 out of 10 from me. Now it's Dyson versus Lego. That sounds a bit iffy. It was spinning around. It got it all. And it has most definitely made it to the bin. So it's gotta be 10 out of 10. But it's picked it up. Is it retrievable? Seems to all be in there. Couldn't do much better. 10 out of 10. Picking up the pastas, not that hard, until the busy feet come in and start crunching it into your carpets. Let's see how the Dyson gets on. Can't ask for any more than that. And what I'm liking is it's still picking up all the small particles, and you can see all of that building up nicely. It's another 10 out of 10 for the Dyson. Oh, let's see how the Shark gets on. Got it all out. You can see all the bits in there, along with lots of the little small particles and the dust that is still coming out of the carpet as well. It's another 10 out of 10 for the Shark. Safety first. Shark versus glass. Let's go. It's kicking some of the glass out the back. Thought it was doing a good job. But a lot of it is blocked. To empty the head. Most of it is in the head. Or, no, there's nothing in the hose. Must be in the canister. Not bad. There is still glass lying around. Will it do it? Yes. The smaller, the better. 7 out of 10. Let's see how the Dyson gets on. Oh no. It's jammed between hair detangling technology. Picked it up, no problem, it just gets jammed in the head. Empties nicely. All in all, it did the job, but it was getting blocked. Chucking bits out the back and clogging the head. I think it's a 5 out of 10. What's the true bin capacity and how well can it pick up cornflakes? That's about half a box, not a whole box, because it's never going to pick up a whole box. Shark, do your job.
All this stuff.
That's it, jam. It's not even a quarter of a box. Let's say a quarter of a box was achieved in around a minute.
Oh, Dyson didn't like that at all.
If you get an urge to back up, vacuum up, cool flakes. The Dyson's the one to go for. Maneuverability is key. You have a battery powered vacuum to make you faster, but you want to be able to move. Let's have a look at an assault course. We're going to go round the Jenga towers, we're going to come between the car, round the back here, and we're coming along round the football, and we're going to make sure we get underneath the tight space and finishing up back where we were before. Let's see how quick and easy it is to do.
Right.
Am I picking up everything?
Yeah, it's supposed to be, yeah. Should have offered her a reward for this.
What?
Should have offered her a reward for this.
Stop the clock. Well, I nearly knocked the tower over. I'm clearing it up. Oh. Overall maneuverability for me, probably a 6 out of 10. Overall, the Dyson is reasonably light when you're using it. I like the fact it rolls on the ball and it does twist. You get used to being able to twist it and turn it on really tight spaces. It's better on hard floor than it would be on carpet, which is to be expected because the grip decreases. Overall, score-wise for maneuverability on the Dyson, I'd give it 7.5 out of 10. So is it Dyson or is it Shark? Which one would we choose? For me, the Dyson is an out and out winner. The biggest downside of the Dyson is simply the cost. It is at the higher price point. It is a lot of money, but in the majority of tests, it stands head and shoulders above the Shark. It's lighter, it's more maneuverable, the battery will last longer, it just feels better all the way around. Although you're paying more money for it, I believe it would last longer. Would I buy a Shark though? Potentially, yes. For £190, as they currently are at time of filming, it is a good vacuum. It will do the job, and it's not bad at all. I just don't like how heavy it is and how long I believe it would last. Having used many, many vacuums over the years, I think this will break reasonably quickly. Thanks very much for watching. We hope you found it useful. Please do click the subscribe button, turn on the notifications so you get a heads up of when we publish one of our videos. We publish a weekly Behind the Cleans video so you can watch everything that happens behind the cleans at Vapor Clean, and lots more hints and tips will be coming your way. Thanks for watching.